Let's look at the uterine cycle. Remember, we have two cycles, the ovarian cycle and the uterine cycle. The uterine cycle occurs in concert with the ovarian cycle. So I introduced you to the phases of the uterine cycle earlier. Recall that they are the menstrual phase, the proliferative phase, and the secretory phase. In the three phases, the menstrual phase occurs from days 1 to 5, proliferative is from day 6 to day 14. So that coincides with the follicular phase of the ovarian cycle. The secretory phase coincides with the luteal phase. If you recall, that's from day 15 to day 28 of the ovarian cycle. The diagram in the center here is showing you how the endometrium changes thickness. It starts off fairly thick and then gets fairly thin, and then it starts getting thicker and thicker and thicker, and then eventually it'll get thinner. Now what we need to do is discuss the details of the uterine cycle. So the first phase of the uterine cycle is the menstrual phase. So this occurs when your estrogen and progesterone levels are declining because the corpus luteum degenerated. Remember, there was no fertilization. No fertilization means the corpus luteum degenerates. Therefore, there's no production of estrogen or progesterone. So the menstrual phase does correspond to the period of menstruation. So during menstruation, you have decreased blood delivery to the endometrium. So if there's less blood being delivered to the endometrium, the tissue dies and it sloughs into the vagina. So that's what causes menstrual flow. At the end of menstruation, now the second part of the uterine cycle occurs, which is called the proliferative. So what the uterus is doing is it's preparing for the fertilized ovum in case it's fertilized. So to prepare, the endometrium lining has to develop. The layer grows, the glands get bigger, the smooth muscle gets thicker, and the cervical glands are secreting mucus. The development of the lining and the things that are occurring here is caused by the increased estrogen levels. The next phase then is the secretory phase, and it's going to begin as the endometrium then is preparing for implantation. So it prepares for implantation by doing the following. And by implantation, what we mean is we're implanting the zygote, right, the fertilized egg, in the wall of the uterus. The secretory phase then, you have an increase in blood supply. There's enlarged glands that secrete glycogen. Why would you want glycogen there? Think about that. Cervical secretions that form a plug, okay, and that's due to progesterone levels going up. Now, let's say fertilization doesn't happen now. So the body's prepared for it, but let's say it doesn't happen. So if fertilization does not occur, the corpus luteum degenerates, and the follicular phase begins all over again the next month.